take it too far to say that we cannot pretend now. Wasn't ever enough to have just everything you want. In your shadow I found a place to hide me from my own thoughts. And if I ever got lost, you find a way to bring me home. And
I'm not afraid to die. We on the top and we ain't gonna fall. This an obsession, a habit you call. We hitting automatic, never stall. Only got one tactic, do it all. I'm from the bottom, I hate what I saw. I couldn't walk, so I learned how to crawl. They wanna talk when you're back to the wall. So I say let them, I ain't moving small. Money grows from my intuition.
Hello and welcome to UTD Overwatch. I'm Megan, your one and probably only caster for tonight. So we're up against the Pickaxes from Cameron University, Oklahoma for the OWCC.
I'm here to spot you, but you have to
starting out here, we will see a Zarya Lucio comp on both sides, along with the Genji.
We will be the lightning that rises us.
Right, so Petal, just to clarify, Petal is it's good. He is on an alt account, and he will be rolling out on the Sojourn today. Proxy just putting in some poke damages. Savior takes down Immersion. Ooh, Proxy goes down to the melee from Jukebox. Jukebox putting in some work and just. The entirety of UT Dallas just pushing the pickaxes back. We see Savior dribbling a ball on point. As a cap. Proxy will come behind and try to take the point and just distract some of the UTD players, but will go down almost immediately. While BG Ultimate will take down Petal. The pickaxes are trying to recontest, try and get onto this bridge and just push back against UTD. But they will opt to go around to the white room as Jukebox gets right clicks himself to death. And that's a huge opening for the pickaxes as they will take down Stasis. And just move on to this point and cap while with UTD at 50%. Falsher just trying to keep his team alive as they pull back and also will rotate White Room. Seems they opted for the bridge and Ultimate pops the barrage but gets cancelled by Stasis with the dash. As Kosher lays down the amp and just gets some picks along with Petal. That's a huge team wipe there from UT Dallas and they will retake the point. Pickaxes are coming back in with God, that's a boot from Ultimate onto Kosher. Huge pick for him. But Petal will pull out the overclocked and get Proxy. Stasis doesn't get anything with the blade there. Just creating some space for his team. Pickaxes will have their Graviton Surge and the Nano for this fight against UT Dallas's Grav as well. Jukebox pops the Grav and only gets Ray, but the Pickaxes do get two. We got the Zarya 1v1 coming out, but Immersion does drop low and will eventually be taken out. KFC just put an... just keeping his team alive from the sidelines, but eventually gets beamed down by Jukebox as Kosher takes down BG. And UT Dallas will take round one of Lijiang Tower.
My equal.
Right, as we go into control center here, Stasis does swap over to the soldier.
Everything's going.
Pickaxes are really trying to get to point here by starting off with the Symmetra teleport. Just trying to get there before UT Dallas. But Stasis does go to a Junkrat. Both sides opt for the Junkrat, actually. Proxy gets taken down almost immediately as he steps onto point. Stasis takes an array. This will cause the pickaxes to have to move back as they do just keep getting picked off by UT Dallas. Hell, this is going into the spawn almost. Just keeps putting pressure onto the pickaxes, just holding them at this choke. Trying to get as much time as they can on the point. Ooh, cheeky play from Petal there as he moves around the corner and just takes down BG immediately. Ooh, Immersion does get revenge and takes down Petal. Dude, Dallas will have to move back here. Jukebox does have the grab for this fight, and so he opts to use it, just melts everybody who gets caught. UT Dallas do still have the amplification matrix and the overclock from Petal and Kosh. What a fascinating amplification matrix on the corner here. Gosh. It doesn't seem to work out as they can't really put any damage through that corner. So they just opt for just going straight forward. And Xavier just literally at the spawn door is touching. UT Dallas is just playing with their food. All the ults in the banks from either side are popped, but Stasis is the only one who gets a lot of Stasis and Xavier just getting the ultimate advantage there. Ooh, Stasis just propels himself into ultimate, which does seem to fall to his doom. Stasis in the chat, so sad. UT Dallas do manage to keep the pickaxes from capping and take Lijiang Tower.
Play of the
I was running.
So we're going back in here on King's Row this time. Y'all did get to see me there for a second before the break. A little embarrassing, but you know, it is what it is. But Kosh and swaps out for Tinspire. And Doi comes in as well. No subs on the side of the pickaxes, though. Jukebox here on the Junker Queen. Not sure if he will stick on this, as UT Dallas are known to kind of troll the casters when they're in the spawn. But Jukebox does roll out with the Junker Queen. We got to see the Junker Queen game today, as Kettle takes the first pick onto BG Ultimate with a headshot immediately. Proxy 1v1 Jukebox in hotel. Grey Wolf doing his job, keeping his team alive, keeping them all full, as Immersion does get naded by Doi. Sinfire goes down to Immersion on the Hog. The Hog is a very interesting pick, as you don't see it used often in Collegiate. And there goes Petal with two picks. Grey Wolf does res KFC, but Stasis takes down Proxy. Petal gets two with the Dragon Strike. Takes down both pickaxe's supports. UT Dallas will take checkpoint A. Oh. Pickaxes do just let UT Dallas take that point and opt to contest them on the next checkpoint. What's good is just getting pick after pick. Jukebox uses the Rampage. Takes down two. The pickaxes will have three ults for this next fight, which should open things up for them. Oh, but KFC does swap over to the Moira. Stasis does have Blade, but Doi doesn't have the Nano yet, so it's unlikely we're going to see a Nano Blade here. Oh. But Immersion does get the hook onto Jukebox. Stasis puts in a bit of damage, gets a pick, but nothing else other than that. Grey Wolf pops the Valkyrie, just keeping his team alive, trying to go and contest the point with Immersion. Doi just sitting on cart. Just keeping it moving. Proxy does take down Petal. Stasis gets two. Immersion does take down Tinspire. Immersion uses the full Hog. But it gets cut short by Jukebox on the Junker Queen. Petal uses the dragons to create some space for his team. It looks like UT Dallas will be taking the next checkpoint. On point C here, there is a lot of high ground. BG uses the overclock. Just putting in some pick damage, but ultimately no picks from him. Stasis does take down Immersion, and Jukebox does get Ray. Jukebox gets BG with the knife and drags him over. Stasis with two headshot picks. Stasis' blade didn't really get much there, unfortunately. But KFC and Proxy do have their ults, as Immersion does swap to the ball. Hope to contest the point a little bit longer. Proxy does take down Petal with the spin. Jukebox, and two. Immersion just holding on to this point for dear life as Jukebox just takes them all down. Huge stagger onto Ray there. And UT Dallas practically rolled the pickaxes on their attack. Let's see how the pickaxes decide to turn the tide and hopefully put up a better fight this time.
Initiating match.
Right, so each teams have picked their heroes. It looks Joy is on the. Oh, is he gonna swap off his Zenyatta?
Avoid their bullets.
So there will be a Zenyatta coming out from each side, but Immersion is on the Winston. Interesting pick. But it would be very good to just jump in, just rush down UT Dallas with this monkey pig. The ultimate just looking for an opening pick here on the Hanzo out of spawn. Hasn't gotten anything just yet. As the pickaxes do push their way in past the gates and under the statue. Jukebox does get Immersion though. Pickaxes will likely have to fall back here and just regroup and get their tank back. Ooh, BG almost takes down, but Stasis does get him with the rockets, as it's good, gets a Storm Arrow kill onto Proxy there.
Hello. Hey.
Immersion here up on that high ground, just forcing UT Dallas down. But BG does take down Petal, which is a huge pick. Although they are without one of their supports. Immersion jumps in and immediately gets punished. BG just trying to get some picks here. Tinspire goes for this cheeky amp matrix in the back. On his own, putting in some damage onto the pickaxes. He will get forced out of that high ground by the Moira orb, though.
Cannot
Pickaxe is just doing their best to stay alive, but Stasis does pop the visor. Which brings out the trance from KFC. Petal does invest the dragons, but gets rocked to death by immersion. Doi still has his trance online, which will be incremental for this next fight. BG Ultima gets taken down immediately in while still in spawn there. Pickaxes really have to figure out what the strat is here to just try and get this point. As Immersion does swap over to the Sigma, sort of play back with his team rather than jumping in. Immersion will have his Flux here in just a second. There it is. Sinspire does go down. BG pulls out the Bob. Just hope to get a little bit more, just a little bit more damage on his, on for his team. With only 20 seconds left, the pickaxes are going to have to try and pull out something huge here as BG Ultimate does swap to the Echo. BG Dallas does have both their support ults online against Immersion's Flux, which forces the trance. Gets taken down immediately. And the pickaxes just can't contest as they're all wiped out by UT Dallas. That was an incredibly just... That was just a steamroll from UT Dallas. Unfortunately, the pickaxes do go down, are down 2-0. Good job for the side of UT Dallas. Petal with the play of the game with the 2 with the Dragon Strike, 3 on the Hog.
Kiss, sweet like poison. You know you make me reckless. I'll run, but you are friction. Your touch feels like heaven. You make me hate all my sins. You are my religion. My religion. I have a million reasons to leave you, but I have a billion reasons to keep you. I have a million reasons to leave you, but I have a billion reasons to keep you.
make you feel good? Don't you wanna feel good, good, good? Sometimes I wish that we could go back before you got hurt, hurt, hurt. When before I was scared,
you were scared.
Now I'm feeling,
now you're feeling
prepared. Don't you wanna feel good? Don't you wanna feel good, good, good?
When you say you were leaving, I thought that you meant it. I played the victim, you start as indifferent. Hindsight comes standard with rose-colored lenses. Hate to admit it, you're better off. Now you're too afraid to look, too scared to miss it. We're night and day, solar eclipses. Too afraid to look, too scared to miss it. We're night and day, solar eclipses.
Kids screaming in the cradles, profanities. Some days I feel skinnier than all the other days. Sometimes I can't tell if my body belongs to me. I love everything. Fire spreading all around my room. My world's so bright, it's hard to breathe, but that's alright. Hush.
with another caster.
You can just call me Vic?
Yep.
It's gonna just... Loving the chat right now going on.
Giggles in fox spirit.
Oh, good God.
So on Ball State Raid, we got Manwiener. You can't see Ghost.
Spency. Raven Strider.
And Yakester. Oh, and immediately paused.
So it looks like we got two Zarya's, two Genji's. So Mara coming out on the other side.
Yep. Can't wait to see some more Sojourn play. Sojourn is always fun to watch. I've been having a lot of fun playing her as of late. Mm-hmm. Played her quite a bit today.
All right. Team's looking pretty similar, minus the Sojourn and some more.
Abdallah gotta hand crank his GPU real quick, according to Banthapudu in the chat.
Oh, goodness. Go to that manual.
As we're paused, at least we have this entertaining chat to
she's heating
gander.
Up.
Pedal power. Hamster power. Wow. We got a lovely sense of humor around here.
They've got the wrecking ball trying to power their PCs.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Currently doing cardio to up my FPS.
Ain't no way.
Gotta get to the gas station to refill the GPU.
Okay, our three viewers are getting some content here. This is great. All right, looks like we're ready to go.
Yeah, we're about to go back in. Abdallah is all good.
They got the wrecking ball back on the bike.
Exactly.
Yeah. Yep. Okay.
Don't be surprised to hear Ball State Red's Zarya's name a lot.
Yeah. The following statements we are not responsible for.
We're just doing our jobs. Like, yeah.
Right, looks like we got Zarya Zarya.
Oh no, not again.
Got it. Awesome. Okay.
So smart. Oh, Manwiener does take down Petal.
Yep.
And just to clarify, Petal is, it's good. He is on an alt account.
Yep. And it looks like Raven Strider is about to get ult.
Ball State is rotating onto the point as Petal puts some damage from the high ground here. As Tinspire does take down Raven, but Ghost does take down Abdallah.
Rikashir is taken out at this point, and looks like the other team got Zarya with ult.
Ooh, Manwiener goes down to the jukebox. Headshot.
Tinspire, Abdallah got getting ult as well, and the ult on the other side wasted.
Ooh. UT Dallas do take the point back from Ball State just barely. I'll stay at 31%. Tinspire and Zala do have their ults online against Manwiener's grab.
Let's see if he can get it in this time. Cheer goes down. Tinspire drops the ult and is immediately shut down.
UT Dallas will be forced to fall back as Ball State Red move onto the point.
Looks like the point's going to be back on Ball State Red. He's going to have to contest now. Petal's back on Sojourn. We've got two ults on UT Dallas, and we've got one Lucio ult on Ball State Red. See how this goes.
Ghost will is about to have his Dragon Blade. Who knows whether he will wait for Raven Strider's nano or not. Oh, but Raven Strider does go down as it's good pops. Petal pops the overclocks and gets two. Ghost does go without the Nano Blade, but does get a pick. Abdallah takes down his opposing Zarya as well as the Lucio, as UT Dallas will flip the point back in their favor. These fights are going very back and forth.
Let's see who can hold the point long enough to win this round. So we got three ults on the side of Ball State Red. Probably gonna drop them all. Are they gonna save them?
Oh, so there comes out the EMP from Spency. Hell does get some picks just to even out the score.
Oh, yeah, and he pulls out the Nano Blade. Let's see what happens.
Oh, Kasha does get hacked, so can't do much with the blade and just gets taken down. Yep.
We got a near team wipe on the side of UT Dallas. Let's see if they can bring it back.
Yep, Ball State have only just need 5% more. I don't think anybody's gonna be able to touch in time.
Nope.
Yep, so Ball State will take round one of Busan.
That was a pretty interesting back and forth between UT Dallas and Ball State.
Yeah, absolutely. Very different from what we just saw with Dallas against the pickaxes.
Yeah.
Which was a...
They were playing a little cheeky there.
A very undeniable sweep against the pickaxes.
Indeed.
But now UD Dallas has a bit more of a challenge to go up against.
Looks like we are getting Kashyyr on Samara here.
Sombra?
Sombra. Whoops!
Don't worry, I called Moira Mercy the other day, so... But we will see Spency pulling out the Sojourn to match Petal. Hell takes down Ghost. Huge opening. They're just picking down each player on the side of Ball State.
Yep, near team wipe on the side of Ball State. Looks like they're gonna get to the blue.
They will take point first. Dollar got some good energy in the bank here. 94. Now he's at max charge. He does take down Manweener. I did hear that in the next patch for Overwatch 2, there are going to be a few nerfs onto Sombra. I believe Sombra, definitely Zarya, and I think two others, if I'm not mistaken.
Currently, I think Moira and Sombra are in the meta right now.
Absolutely.
It looks like Tinspire's got the array right now, ultimate, and we're going to see when that's going to come down. Looks like UGD is getting battered by... Nope.
Looks like they will kick through another almost team wipe. Just keep getting 4Ks on the side of UT Dallas. Seems that round one of Busan was just a warm-up for them. Mm-hmm. Just getting back into the flow of things. Spency does get a quick pick onto Tinspire, but it is immediately canceled out as he is taken out.
Three ults on the side of UT Dallas. Three ults on both sides right now. Oh. Right. Nope, never mind. You can't ghost cut taken out.
Ooh, Kasha takes down two. his EMP. Pedal does take out the overclocked. Ooh, gets Spency. That was a very dominant round two on the side of UT Dallas.
Indeed, they definitely going back this round. Let's see what happens next. 1-1. I am correct about them.
Ready for battle.
Now, coming up on this next point, we've got 1-1. I think this is just about how to see if UTD can keep it together, the teamwork, or if Ball State is going to break it apart.
This does swap to the Genji for this round. Probably get some nano blades back on the board. Archer gets two.
Petal gets Nan and Raven Strider and Yoxter.
UT Dallas are just pushing them into their spawn. Just gets a quick hack onto Ghost and teleports back. Dallas will cap the point first. Spency just scoping out UT Dallas' backline, looking for a nice hack onto one of the supports. He does get Tinspire.
Petal
spots him out.
It's over.
Abdallah does get two. He just keep pushing them back into their spawn.
Get out in time there.
Raven does have the amp maker for this fight. Ooh, but Abdallah does pop the nav. Raven doing his best to keep his team alive through it. Spency does get taken down by Petal. Abdallah just taking down his opposing Zarya. Dicks. Kasha gets Raven.
Catch you later.
Petal will have the overclocked along with Kosher's EMP against Ball State's grab.
Looks like UKent Ghost and Spency are also nearing on their ults, but see if we can get to the point in time. At this point, it looks like UDD's pretty much got it on hold.
Railgun powered and ready to fire.
Does put in the grab, but it gets two. Pops it overclocks. Yikester pulls out the beat in return, but they can't touch the point in time, and UTD takes Busan.
Nice.
A lot of ults used in that last fight. It does ultimately go in UTD's favor. Petal does get play of the game. Love to see it. No surprise there.
Now.
Pretty strong.
Pretty dang strong, yeah.
Absolutely.
Take it out.
going back in, we will see another King's Row.
Now, so far it seems to have been a back and forth, although UTD has managed to take the point last time. What are you hoping to see in this round?
I'm actually looking to see some more pedal play, because he's really known for that hit scan. Although we will see Abdallah on this Doomfist here as they are on defense.
Oh, never mind.
Going to Zarya. But I won't complain because I main Zarya, so I'm totally okay with seeing some Zarya.
Fair enough.
But I do want to see some big picks out of Petal some more.
There's always a way to make something.
Gotta love Petal. Like, just, he's a great hit scan player. And he's former contenders as well. Or so I've heard. Kasher just on this high ground here, just scoping out Ball State's comp. Ball State just looking to get past this gate here, but Ghost gets taken down immediately by Petal with the right click.
Looks like UTD is immediately going in here. Ball State having trouble getting to bed.
Ooh, Spency does take down Petal with the headshot on the Hanzo here. Manwiener is at full charge though, so that will be a lot of damage from Ball State. Spency takes down Jukebox with the Storm Arrow. Ball State do take a quick cap on point A of King's Row here. It's good trades with Manwiener.
Looks like a sheer will switch.
Kasher does pull out the Genji Mirror. As UTD play around this corner here, just trying to get in some damage and hopefully an opening pick. Abdallah, ooh. Manweeder does get the nano and uses the grab. That's a huge fight out of Ball State, as they do invest 3 ults into that fight, which does turn out in their favor. For this next fight, ooh, Abdallah does take down 2. Interesting there. UG Dallas will have the Amplification Matrix for this next fight, though. Gets a dash kill on the Manwiener.
And there goes Spency as well.
Ooh, Yakster does take down Jukebox though. As Abdallah just runs into Ravenstrider.
That is another near team kill for UTD.
Manwiener really needs to get some charge off the bubbles here. He does get up to 60 with charge. He will need a little bit more if he wins. Oh, there we go. About 90. Kasher pops the blade into the back line of Ball State and gets Raven, but is taken down by Ghost. The beat comes out from Yakster here just to help push forward. Oh, Jukebox just barely, just does not manage to escape. Petal does have the overclock here.
Looks like Hanzo is in fact already pulled. Let's see if he pulls it out at this point, or he's gonna wait. Looks like both brothers have the ult on the other side.
Yep. since he pulls out the Dragon Strike. Gets a bit of damage, but ultimately no picks. Ooh, it's good. Petal falls low. Jukebox invested.
Did you get the overclock for Sojourn?
Yep. Ooh, gets a pick on a Raven, who did swap to the Baptiste, forgot to mention. Takes down three. That is a team wipe on the side of UZ Dallas. Fancy. Oh, the Ball State just take this move up onto this high ground to put some pressure onto UT Dallas. Getting Kosher off the high ground.
Looks like a grab does
Ooh,
go
huge
in.
Huge grab from Manwiener. Ooh, Dallas goes down to his own right click. That's a huge fight out of Ball State and will likely help them move this cart into the next checkpoint. Petal is just kind of staggered behind here in the cart and does not feel the need to contest.
We do have two arrays in this fight though on both sides, so let's see what happens here.
Ooh, big pick on the Yangster there as Petal and Jukebox try to get back to their team. Manwiener is at full charge though. Will be pulling out a lot of damage for his team.
Looks like they're pretty even matched here, but looks like they
pulls out the blade. Ooh, the Yixer pulls out. Yixer and Raven pull out their ult in return to keep their team up. This fight is very back and forth. Just picks falling on either side. But the cart is still moving forward. All the meanwhile, as Manwiner just sits there.
Some poke damage. Efforts don't seem to be enough to stop the cart from moving at this moment. Back and forth, back and forth. They need to find a way to take advantage here. Three ults on the side of 2 on Ball State Red.
Oh, big grab from Abdallah. Spencey falls as Gaster takes down Kandala. Health did pull out the overclock, but did not manage to get any picks while it was active. And UT Dallas just takes out 3 from Ball State.
But let's see if it's enough to even stop the cart from moving here. They're so close to the goal.
Kosher just diving into Ball State just to get some damage in, but does escape. Petal does take down Ghost. Raven does pop the amplification matrix. Kosher brings out the blade and gets Ghost. Ball State only have about 10 seconds left. It does not seem like likely that they will touch the point in time. They find Yixter on that high ground and take him out. Manwiener just barely gets to the point on this ball. It will not be very long lived as he does fall almost immediately. Ooh, the deflected. Oh, I thought that was a deflected grab. No, that was just a normal grab from Abdallah, which did manage to catch all of Ball State. 0-2, switching sides. Initiating match. UT Dallas will be on the attack this time, and I'm excited to see what they will pull out. Maybe they'll try and troll a bit. Who knows? They are known to be quite silly, goofy lads.
They were being a little cheeky some of those past few rounds.
Yep. Nope, looks like they will stick with the signature comp.
The eye will not fail.
I do see a hand on the other side.
Yeah, as well as the Reaper from Ghost. Tasha just doing a little jig.
Let us proceed with haste. Is there nothing you can do for this pain?
I think of it as fuel beneath the flame.
Conversation got cut short between Reaper and Moira there.
Yeah.
Four, three, two, one. Attackers incoming. Defend objective A.
Dallas just pushed through the choke here. Ooh, Spencey does get a hack on the pedal. Yep. Spencey does fall low and has to retreat with the translocator. Still does take down Yakester. This is a huge opening for the side of UT Dallas as they can just push in. As Ball State has not as much healing as before.
Like sticking with this combo is the way to go.
Yeah. They decided to take no risks this time. That's a lot of damage coming out from Petal there with the slowing field. Right click.
Got a lot of ult charge on both sides.
This tower is hacked on the high ground. TD do fall low. They are managing to stay alive.
Out.
Ball State does manage to hold on to point A. Yuzhao's only managed to get one pick. Weird little going behind on his high ground. What an odd play from them. Just like, that was a huge grab from Abdallah. Takes down. Abdallah is huge on this Zarya. And UT Dallas do take the point. That was a very weird like wraparound from the Sojourn and the Lucio onto that high ground.
That did not work in their favor.
Raven does pull out Coalescence just to push UT Dallas back. Yep, Manwiener takes down two. He's hiding behind the phone box. Gets spotted out. Has to go get the Mega. Kasher does have the blade as well as the overclock and the beat on the side of UT Dallas, as opposed to Ball State's EMP. Although they, yep, there goes EMP, but the pedal does get one with the overclock. Kasha brings out the blade and gets Raven. That fight did work out in UT Dallas' favor, but Ball State will have the Death Blossom and the beat for this next fight. Reflected onto Ghost from Tosh. Pushed the button there. Manwiener does use the grab though, which does almost wipe the entirety of the UCP. Huge stagger onto Abdallah there. They won't have any ults this time, but you guys will have the Matrix and the grab.
I just want to say, Spencey is having a time with Sombra here. Sombra is getting a lot of kills on the side of Ball State.
Yeah. Petal gets two with the right click. The railgun. Fight one from UT Dallas, and they still have the Amp Matrix. Pulse 8 does have the Coalescence online. We'll see whether they want to contest, keep contesting, or if they'll just let UT take this next point. So they will contest. Push in with the Coalescence from Raven. Spencer drops the EMP and does use it onto Petal on the high ground, but gets taken down. Petal just fighting for his life. Does get taken down eventually, as Ball State do manage to hang on to point B. Payload to 2.6. Keeping his team healed up. Go back in. Oh, it does use the grab and his opposing Zarya. Pulls out the Matrix and Metal gets. Metal gets. Two railgun kills. Success. This cart is moving very smoothly into winning point. So you have to get on it really quickly.
Catch you later.
Trying to contest as much as they can. Ghost does have the Death Blossom. It does decide to pop it and does get Dala. Ooh. Does bring out the beat Kosher with the blade. That's huge from UT Dallas. They may be able to just get this point in overtime.
Matrix comes out.
Ghost is on that tracer. Manwiner switches over to the ball just to try and contest. Just barely gets there in time. All of the teams are being taken out one by one. Dixter does have the beat, though, just to keep his team alive for that little bit much longer. But UT Dallas does win Kings Row and beats Ball State 2-0. GG's all around in the chat.
It's pretty dang close and really scary from that Sombra over there. That could have gone really badly if that EMP had hit.
Yeah. This was a huge grab from Abdallah. Really helped get them that first point. And that Yeah, that was a good showing from UT Dallas today. Winning both their matches 2-0.
Yeah, it was pretty good seeing Sojourn, very obviously.
Yes.
The Sombra on the team was definitely a threat on both sides. In general, Sombra is big in the meta right now. Sojourn.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, and Abdallah was amazing on that Zarya today, just putting in the work, as always. You love to see, like, his Zarya is insane. And Petal popping off, Jukebox, great on the support, great Lucio player. Ball State did have some really good players. They definitely held their own, even though it was a 2-0. They did come out great.
Pretty ghost claiming could have gone either ways had it not been several points in the match, but
yeah. They almost had Kings Row there, but UT Dallas did just barely manage to sweep them under the rug. So, yeah, thanks for joining us today. We'll see you next time.
Peace out.
Goodbye.